Hey guys, welcome back to new video, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use preferences data store in our projects. So why preferences data store and what is preferences data store? Well, if you want to store any small amount of data, so you can use this preferences data store, because in preferences data store we actually store that value in a key value pair. Basically, if you want to store username, so you have to create any kind of key for that, and then after you are going to store that key value pair in the preferences data store. Previously we are going to perform this kind of thing with shared preferences, but shared preferences was not that flexible as our preferences data store. So if you want to see why this is more flexible over shared preferences, well, simply go through this code lab. And page number 4, you are going to get the comparison. So you can see safe to call on UI thread, share preferences was not, because sometimes it will crash your application. And in preferences data store, it will use under the hood dispatches.io, so that is why it is not crashing, alright. Handle data migration, shared preferences was not able, but our preferences data store is able to do that, so that is why it is more flexible over shared preferences. Alright, so enough talking, let's get started with the coding part. So first, build.gradle model app level file as usual. So you have to add these dependencies in your project, and these are some extra dependencies. If you want to use it, please use. If you don't, please don't. And after that, go in our activity underscore main.xml, and I have my layout created previously. So if you want to create this, you can create, but I have my GitHub repository link in description. Go there, copy all this layout part. All right. So I just show you the IDEs. So text view, the text view is name, first one, and the second one is age. This is edit text. In there we are going to enter our name, and in here we are going to enter our age. All right. So on the pressing of this button, we are going to save that key value pair in the preferences data store, and immediately we are going to observe that data over there. All right. So I think I'm clear what I'm going to do in this tutorial. So back to main activity, and here I just create a late, sorry, my laptop was slow. So what the heck. So binding, activity main binding, and we are going to initialize this. So binding data binding util set content view, pass this second is our r dot layout dot activity main. All right, so remove this. All right, so we are finished with this main activity. Now I am creating a new class. So right click, new Kotlin class slash file, and I just name this user details. All right, so in here we are going to pass the context. So context. All right, so now I am going to create a wall data store. All right, so this is a type of data store and preferences. So make sure you are choosing this androidx.datastore.preferences.core. All right, so we are going to initialize this with delegate preferences data store. You can see over here we have to pass the name, so I simply give name pref. All right, so it will give an error because we have to attach this variable onto the context. All right, so now we are going to access this data store by using context in our whole project. All right, so now what we are going to do, we are going to take the data and store that data into preferences data store as a form of key value pair. So for that we are going to create some keys. So companion object, so the first one is username. So because this username is a string, so we have to use string preferences key, and in here I've just passed username. All right, so just like that our age, so age is integer type, so use int preferences key and pass age in here. All right, so I think you got. Now we have to Use suspend function in order to store that data, because under the hood, make sure this will work on the dispatchers.io. So that is why we are going to use suspend function. Suspend function, and I'm going to give this name store details. All right. So first one is username, which is a type of string. Second one is which is a type of int. All right. So now I'm using our context. So we are going to access our data store, and simply using edit, just like our shared preferences, we are going to store that data. So it will return me a mutable preferences. So it, and here I am using our username, and just like that, we simply store that data. It, our age, and our age is age. All right. So now we are successfully store our data into the preferences data store as a form of key value pair. So now we are going to take that data. So function get name, and using our context data store dot data, and in here we are going to use map. All right, it will give me a preferences. So simply it give our username, and if it is the case it is null, then simply use Elvis operator. So Elvis operator, what Elvis operator do, if this thing return null, then instead of returning null, it will return this this thing which you return over here. All right. So in my case, I simply give a empty string. All right. So just like that, get name, we have to access our get age. All right. So context data store data map, it give our age, and just like our previous one, if anything is going wrong, or if in any case it will return null, then simply return -1 instead of returning null. All right. So that's it in our user details. So I just recapitulate what we do in this particular class. So first we are going to attach that data store into the context, so that we are going to use anywhere in our project by using context, we should use our data store. All right. So it will simply initialize this thing, and then after we are going to create some keys for our data preferences data store, and using that key we are going to store our data onto on the opposite of this keys, just like our hash map. If you want to see the example, then you should simply take that hash map. All right. So it will store that, and by using these two functions, it will simply return that. All right. So now go in our main activity, and in here, so binding dot save data set on click listener. So I just control click over here. So this is the ID of our button. So main activity save data. All right. So now I simply use the user details. So for that, I need to create that. So user details. And just after the binding initialization, I also initialize our user details. So the context is this, no need to pass the context. All right. So now we use our user details, we store our details by using binding, and enter name text to string trim. All right. So it will return a name. And binding enter age text to string trim to int. All right. So now it will give me error because this is a suspend function, and we have to call the suspend function within a coroutine. So coroutine scope.io launch, and now I simply put this thing into that block, import that io. All right. So just like that, we are going to access the data. So for that, lifecycle coroutine scope launch when created. So using our user details, get our name dot collect, because this is returning a flow, that is why we have to collect that thing. And after collecting, binding set that string into the name. All right. So text it. So that's it. Our name will simply set, and the second one is our age. So for that use here get age, and then after it is basically integer type. So simply cast this thing into a string or convert this thing into a string. So not using name in here, I'm using age. Alright, so that's it. Everything is set up perfectly fine. And now I am running our application and show you how this thing is working in our application. Alright, so our application will run successfully, and you can see by default it will return -1 in the age section, and in the name section it will return empty string. Alright, so now I am going to save some data. So Imansu, and the age is 21. I simply save this, and you can see it will save onto our preferences data store. Now I simply remove this application from my recent activities, and again we are going to open this application, so data store tutorial, and you can see it will store that data into our preferences data store. So if you want to again change this, you can simply change. So my age now I think 22. Save this, and immediately you can observe this data. Alright, so that's all for this tutorial, and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel so that you get regular content regarding Android tutorials. Alright, so thank you for watching this video.